Good morning, Bethel and friends. Yes, let's do a woo! This is going to be church like we've not had church since last year. Okay, and we just want to welcome you all here. We're so excited to have everyone here at the beginning, the very beginning of Bible school. So we are just super excited for everything, for all the kids. We're well over 65 kids. We've got like 15 teens and young adults. And so we are super, super blessed. It's going to be a busy and wild week. So having said that, thank you for your attendance. Thank you for being here. Matt, next slide. Oh, there it is. BBS. So easy a caveman can do it. I'm not sure that's appropriate. And I don't think a caveman could do it. Next slide, Matt. Okay, church calendar. This is all about Bible school this week. There's no baseball reservations to be made. Those are done. We're all going to be going to the curb on the 28th, and we're excited about that because we have 60-plus people going there. So it's all cool. Next slide, Matt. Okay, Bible school is all about the kids, but specifically it's about serving kids and serving in the mission field. And so I know you probably can't read that, but we have two mission entities, as we have for the last couple of years. The first is for our little friend Xander Marshall, and you know he's suffering with a disease called Mito, and the Miller family and the church and many, 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 many other people have been working diligently to earn money to help find a cure. So this is little Xander, and eventually he's coming to worship this morning, so I am so excited. He had an infusion this morning, so he's coming a little bit late, but we're excited to have him here. And so every day, the physical offering, which will happen in these lovely stone baskets, will be earmarked for Xander and finding a cure. The next person that we're looking forward to helping, Matt, and you can't read that one either. But, well, maybe you can. I can't. But it's for John Bruner. John is a resident of Blackwood Township. He's been in 4-H since he was 5 years old, and he's working towards his diamond designation, which is like an Eagle Scout in scouting world. So he has to do a many-layer project. One is to facilitate a day camp, which is going to be focused on shooting, safe shooting, and it's a two-day camp. And then there is a health component to it, and you talk about health and nutrition and how that all helps you do a better job. And so one of the physical parts of his project is to collect 500 boxes of cereal before July 1st. 500, that's a lot. And that is all going to go to ICAP to meet the needs of families who are in dire need of having enough food for their kid. So every day, or as you can, the wagons that we normally use for First Sunday, and we'll have a word about that, we'll be at the back of the church, and we're going to start stockpiling cereal boxes. Whatever kind of cereal you like, anything, any kind of dry cereal, we'll be collecting, and then we're going to donate it to John, who then in turn will donate it to ICAP. John will be here on Tuesday to talk to the kids a little bit about that entity. So, talking about the red wagons, Miss Jenny has something she'd like to say.
I just wanted to thank everybody that brought food last Sunday for the red wagon. This is my first time in my duty as a deacon, and I took it to Salvation Army, and they started thanking me from the time I opened my trunk for the last bag went in. There was a lady in the pantry documenting with every can and putting it on shelves that did not have much food. But I do thank you, and I left Bethel proud.
That's good. Thank you. it's nice when we go to places like the Salvation Army. They're so appreciative of everything. And they have an active pantry. I mean, they meet a lot of needs for homeless and people without food in the county. So, are there any other announcements that need to be made? Well, guess what? It's it. It's, well, no, it isn't. Are there any prayer requests? We want to do our prayers before we start. Are there any prayer requests from the congregation this morning? Needs? Joys? Okay, then I can pray. Let's do it. Father, we thank you for this day, for the sunshine that's pouring down upon us, and for the week that lies ahead. We're so excited to share your word, your truth with the kids of Bethel and Blairsville and Indiana and Homer City. We have a great mission field, and we hope to do great things through the ministry of Jeff. But it's not about Jeff, and it's not about us. It's about your son, Jesus Christ, and the foundation that he has laid down for us. It's on his love and his mission in the world that we are to carry out. And so we lift that up first and foremost. Be with our kids. Help them to have a great and wonderful time. Help them to learn new and wonderful things. Help the staff and the volunteers and everyone who has worked so, so very hard to get this all pulled together. Give us patience and compassion and flexibility and the spirit of cooperation. And be with Jeff. Father, we are so thankful that his first experience went so well. And he's worked out all the bugs, and it's going to be so smooth that we just know it's going to be a wonderful week. We lift up all of that to you, because you are a God who can take all of that and make everything happen. Be with those who can't be with us. Be with the sick, with the infirm. Meet people where their needs are, and we will give you all the glory. And to that, the people of God would say, amen. Okay, Mr. Oh, and if you are on staff as a volunteer or whatever, please stay afterwards, and we'll congregate up here for a little bit. Jeff wants to share some stuff so that we can have fun.
Amen. Amen. Welcome, or Bethel, good to see you. Hello?
Hello.
Good morning. It's great to see everybody here. I'm so excited. My name is Pastor Jeff for the week, and I'm going to be here to call you all. Yeah. Ooga Ooga will be here all week, and I'm going to pump you up with the word of God so you can be strong in God's word like me. Yeah. Although that's impossible, because your puny little spirit man muscles will pop out of your flesh, and that's so unattractive. Yeah. We're going to have a great time this week. Obviously, it's back to the Stone Age. So we've got volcanoes, and we've got cavemen, and we've got lots of rocks. And everything will be tied into that theme, which I'm going to present to you. This is such a privilege for me this morning, because it gives you the opportunity to capture the vision of what's going to happen this week, and to be a part of what we're going to be teaching the kids. So I am so thankful to Terry and the leadership of the church for letting me come in on a Sunday morning and sharing this with you. We're going to have a lot of kids, a lot of helpers. This place is going to be literally rocking. So I'm very excited about that. So back to the Stone Age. This week, 9 to 11:30 every day. Everybody now knows that by now. The theme song. I'm going to ask all the kids that are going to be here for Vacation Bible School that want to join me on the platform right now for our theme song this week, which is Standing on a Rock. Come out here, kids. Let's give them a big hand. Yeah, now spread out all the way across the front. Normally, during Vacation Bible School, these pews do not serve my personal need for movement, so we have the kids just stretch out all over the open spaces. Come on up here, guys. Good to see them. What a good-looking group, huh? Yeah, got lots of room over here, guys. Lots of room that way. Move down, everybody. Move down, everybody. Okay. All right. I should go ahead and get out my books so I can teach you. We're going to learn, I don't know how much of this you've learned. Knock over a kid, killing children before we start vacation Bible school. Hooray! This is our theme song, Standing on the Rock. And what we're going to do is to learn some of it, not all of it. I can see the clouds roll in. Let's do that. I can see the clouds roll in. I can feel the wind. It tries to shake me, but I will not be moved. My feet are, and this is what we're going to do a lot of, my feet are on the rock. Yeah, with my bad knee. Yeah. All right, let's try that. I can feel the clouds roll in. I can feel the wind. It's, you can try it. You can try it. It tries to shake me, but I will not be moved. My feet are on the rock. How we doing? How we doing? I feel the energy. I can feel the waters rise. Yeah. I can hear the howling. It tries to haunt me. Oh, don't say, don't care what you say. Fear won't hold me now, because my feet are on the, you got it, Jack. Yeah, Jack. All right. When I feel, this is the chorus. I'm not going to teach you the whole thing. This is the chorus. And everybody should learn this. When I feel my hope about to break, right on your heart, I break. I will lean on your unchanging grace. Yeah, I'm going to write it across there. Let the waters rise and the storm give way. I'll be dancing. 66-year-old man trying to floss.
Danger, danger, Will Robinson, danger.
My feet, yeah. In the rain, my feet are on the rock. All right, that's the chorus. When I feel my hope about to break, I will cling to your unchanging grace. We're going to do this every day, every time we get together. Let the waters rise and the storms give way. Let's floss. I'll be flossing judges. How are we doing? Flossing judges? Yeah. My feet are on the rock. Okay, last part. On Christ's solid rock I stand. On the ground is sinking sand. Uh-huh. On solid... Girl, what is up? Thank you. Attitude, diva. Yeah. Take this stage from me, like your mama. Christ is solid rock I stand on. The ground is sinking sand. So, stomp your feet. Drop your hands. My feet are on the. Dude, I like that. You were awesome. On Christ is solid rock I stand. Other ground is sinking sand, so stomp your feet. Clap your hands. You're ready. Go ahead and put Mr. Matt, my new best friend. He's on sound, at least today. Rich Gibson will be here for the rest of the week. Everybody ready? Let's try this. This is our theme song for Vacation Bible School this week. Oh, I forgot this. Woo! Bring it up, Matt.
I can feel the wind, they try to shake me. I will not be moved. My feet are on the rock. Can we slide off this car? And the earth.
Sin caused and our need for a savior based on that. But it's out of Ezekiel. If you want to turn that next slide, our verse that day, these are not easy kid verses, by the way. I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit in you. I will take your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. And I think we're going to learn that to Joan Jett's classic rock song. Oh, come on. I love rock and roll, but it'll go like this. I will give to you a new heart and a new spirit in you. I will take from you your heart of stone and give you a heart of... Oh, everybody wants to come now, huh? Here's the problem. We start playing these classic rock songs, and all the adults start singing the real words. Like, no. Little Joan Jett, that's how we're going to learn our scripture memory, Ezekiel 36, 26. I want to tell you a story about this. We're going to do this. Dennis, come on up here. Give me a hand. I love this part. I love this part where I start volunteering people. I've told you this all the time. You start looking away like I don't see you anymore. What's your name? You tried that? What's your name?
Ricky. Yeah.
Ricky. Don't lose that number. Ricky, come on. All right. This story is very much tied in to the story of Nicodemus. You know, the idea of I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit in you. I will take your heart of stone and I will give you a heart of flesh. The idea of being born again. That's what's going to eventually have to happen because sin came into the world. Now, I also need Ms. Laura. Come on up here. And you're in charge of the sign. I hope I didn't do this before. If I did, just enjoy it and act like you're seeing it for the first time. Laugh. Make sure I feel good about myself. Okay, so everybody, Miss Laura's going to put up, every time I call for a sign, Miss Laura's going to do a miracle. That'll be good. She'll throw the sign up into the air and everybody will respond as to whatever's on the sign. For example, sign!
Three's Company.
See how that works? Now you wonder, Three's Company, what kind of sign is that? Well, this is the story of Nick at night. Okay, I'm hoping for the kids. I'm hoping that would be stronger. All right, Mr. Nicodemus, right here. Let's hear it for Nicodemus. Jesus. Yeah, who would have guessed he was so tall, right? Jesus. I tell my boys, I have two boys. They're 30 in their 30s now, and they're like 5'8 and 5'9, and they say, Dad. Would it have been so much to ask for 3 more inches on top? Just 3? Yeah, you took it all. Okay, so we're going to tell this story of Nicodemus and this idea of our hearts being turned from a heart of stone to a heart of flesh. Can I help you? yours? Oh, this whole group over here has to go. All right, you got your part. Okay, so when it comes to Nick, you just say your part. When it comes to Jesus, you say your part. And sign!
Three's Company!
All right, here we go. The story of Nick at Night. Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale about a faithful trip. We'll tell it using theme songs and bits from TV clips. Nick arranged a meeting with a man who others claim was the promised one Messiah, and Jesus was his name. Now Nick was raised a Pharisee, but not the status quo. Something in his heart said there's a different way to go, and it's something that we need to know. Jesus preached a message quite radical to some, and a following was hollering that the sovereign one had come. And now the Jews were going to choose, was Jesus Christ the promised one, Mr. Nick?
Master, thank you for agreeing to meet here tonight like this. I want to speak with you alone because...
Sign!
Three's Company!
I know we've never met before, but people say you're a...
Sign!
Perfect Stranger!
I want to know more about you.
What do you want to know?
I know that you are a teacher sent by God. Surely you are.
Sign!
Head of the class!
Because no one could do the miraculous signs you do. But there are so many questions. Tell me about heaven.
Green Acres is the place to be. Land contoured round a crystal sea. You'll just adore your mansion view, but your sinful nature will pass you through.
Sinful nature? What is that?
You know, the laws in the Torah, the story of the Adams family.
The good Lord was a kitten, and he said one forbidden. He should have kept things hidden from Adam's family. But Eve believes a liar who slithered up beside her. Paradise was prior to Adam's family. Da-da-da-da. 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 I had to add the ending because I knew you would do it anyway. Okay.
We know God can't tolerate sin.
Correct. God desires that everyone be saved. He desires...
Sign!
All in the family.
That is why you must be born again.
Born again? How can that be unless man were...
Sign!
Bewitched!
Let me explain so you can.
Sign!
Get smart!
Come and listen to the story about Jehovah up above. Come to earth to demonstrate his passion and his love. God so loved the world that he sent his only son. Believe on him and enter in, the work's already done.
It's not that I don't want to think that that's what you say is true. I just don't think I don't understand being raised a Jew. I think I heard you right. I just believe in you. That's why we call blasphemy. Now what am I to do?
Blasphemy would only be if what I say is false. But what I have to say is not a lie made on impulse. Do I really need to tell you I'm the way, the truth, and the light? Isn't that exactly what you came for, Nick at Night?
All my life we have waited for the coming of the Messiah, God's redemption, the hope of Israel.
You must look at your
sign!
Family ties!
You are Israel's teacher, yet you do not know these things. Your forefathers passed down to you the laws and traditions, but your heavenly
sign!
Father knows best.
God's hope for Israel, the Messiah will not only save the Jews, but Gentiles alike. For all that call upon my name shall be saved.
It's the story of a lovely lady. She's a bride adorned in splendor, dressed in white. She'll be spotless, she'll be pure, without a blemish. A fascinating sight, and the bridegroom will come to get her. You can count on this as much more than a hunch. It's the Church of Jesus Christ, with Jews and Gentiles. We'll all be one big family, the braided bunch. The braided bunch, the braided bunch.
It sounds like...
Sign!
Happy days!
And with that, they all said their good nights.
Good night, Jesus.
Good night, Nick.
Good night, Sue Ellen.
Good night, everyone.
Sign!
Yeah!
That was one of the best news ever! Two guests right here, purple! Good job, guys. Good job. Thanks, fellas. Give a big hand, come on! Day number one is all about the heart of stone. Go ahead and put that second day up there. Does anybody know what kind of stone this is?
Sapphire.
It's blue. Okay, you got that. It's a blue sapphire. Jewish tradition says that the Ten Commandments were written on this kind of stone. Because this is the kind of stone that was most prevalent at the top of Mount Sinai. That's Jewish tradition says that the Ten Commandments, they were written on stone tablets. And the reason it's day two is because the law taught us that we can never make our way back to God. The law taught us that we can never be good enough. Where's Terry? Preach it, brother. You can never be good enough. You can never strive hard enough. It's not within your being because of your fallen nature to be good. We're a depraved people. And the law written on stone tablets showed us. If I wanted to make a correlation, I would go to the Romans Road and I would say, everyone has sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, and the wages of sin is
death.
What is it, good, church?
Death.
Death. Death. The wages of the sin is death. So, I'm going to try to do this. I hope, will this hold me, Terry?
Whoa.
Maybe not. Maybe we shouldn't do that. We'll do this. This is new, but I'm going to try to do it for you. So, these are what I'm going to show you right now. We're going to tell you the story of the Ten Commandments. Commandment number one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and soul and mind and strength. Commandment number two. You shall not worship an idol. You shall not have graven images. You should not, watch it right here, bow your knee to an idol. Commandment number three, do not use God's name in vain. God says, I am the great, I am. Oh, come on. That's a good one. Commandment number four, honor the Sabbath and keep it holy. Day number, you have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday to work. But on Sunday, you should rest. The fifth day is honor your father and mother. And it is the only commandment that has a promise. Does anybody know what that promise is?
So that it will go well with you.
That it may go well with you and you might have a long life in the land that the Lord your God is giving you. That's commandment number five. Commandment number six, all you world people, I know you know this one. Thou shalt not kill except a groundhog. You can kill a groundhog. Thou shalt not kill. Commandment number seven is a tricky one. Thou shalt not commit adultery, which is no pinky. I work on that one too. Especially with kids. Commandment number eight, thou shalt not steal, boys and girls. That's mine. Commandment number nine. Does anybody know? Yeah? Thou shalt not bear false witness. Thou shalt not lie. Commandment number 10, thou shalt not covet. Oh, yeah. Oh, hi, God. Yeah. Yeah, they're right here. I'll just tell them about the Ten Commandments. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll tell them. All right, bye. God said he gave you the Ten Commandments because he loves you. There you go. The Ten Commandments. That's day number two. The law that was written on stone tablets. Day number three. Oh, let's show them the scripture verse there, Matt, if we can. Here it is. For what the law was powerless to do, the law, the commandments, because it was weakened by the flesh, God did by sending us a son in the likeness of sinful man to die. And this song is done to the tune of, hang on, because I know you want to know this. Oh, for what the law was powerless do. God, it was weakened by the flesh. God did by sending us his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh to die.
No more teenagers.
Oh, wrong song. Little Alice Cooper, who is saved, hallelujah. And so that's day number two for what the law was powerless to do. Okay, let's go to number three. What stone is that?
Cornerstone.
That's the cornerstone. Day number three is our gospel. We present the cornerstone, Jesus Christ. And so I'm going to do something that I felt like I was just led to do a little while ago. I need all of these cups passed out so that every adult in the room has one. Everybody needs a cup. You get a cup. Let's maybe there you go. Just pass it down if you like, you know, like the offering plate. Everybody needs a cup. The kids will be learning a song this week called Standing on the Rock. Standing on the Rock. And I choreographed it with a red Soho cup. So everybody gets a cup, like the kids will have a cup during worship. So all you kids, all you children, grab a hold of your cup. You'll need it in a second. Dave, you got your cup? I want you to play. Everybody got a cup? Okay. That's exactly what we're going to do with this. Watch me, and I'm going to teach this to you. Stand strong. You can do it right where you're sitting. God is with you. Stand strong. Now, I know these are massive cannons, and they intimidate like you. I know you're intimidated by this. But you know what? Show me what you got. What's your name?
Patrick.
You going to be here this week, Patrick? I would stay away if I were you. Yeah. Because I would just abuse you really badly. Stand strong. God, these are all signs, is with you. Stand strong. God is for you. Stand strong. And here it is. Jesus is the rock you're on. All right, he is our cornerstone. We can build a foundation on him. The Bible says, the wise man builds his house on the rock. The foolish man builds his house on sand. One more time. Stand strong. God is with you. Stand strong. God is for you. Stand strong. Jesus is the rock you're on. Okay. So what I did was I choreographed this whole song every year. I've been doing this for 30 years. Thank you. So it gets harder and harder to come up with new things. So I'm like, I'm going to choreograph a worship song with the cup. So here's what we're going to do. At some point in time, we get to that chorus. Stand strong. You're going to stand up if you can. If you're able to, you're going to stand up where you are and do it with me, okay? And then I got a surprise for you. All right. Here we go. This is one of our theme songs for worship. It's a song that fits this idea of Jesus' cornerstone. Go ahead, Matt. I learned this on, what's that musical? The Stone the Builders Rejected has become the cornerstone. Go ahead and put us the music on. Pitch Perfect. All right. We're going to try to sing it and do it at the same time, which is no small thing. But you might go. Build your house on the rock. On this land you will be not a man. Build your life. See the kids are going. On the rock. Build your home on the rock. Build your house on the rock. In this land. Build your life on the top. Make your house. Translucent and pure brilliant. And on that stone, God writes a new name for you. A name that only you and He know. And that's Revelations 2:17. And so as we get to the end of our kind of our Roman road walk, we find out that for those who confess with their mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in their heart that God raised Him from the dead, they will have eternal life in a place called heaven, and heaven is where God is. And so here's what we're going to do. Go ahead, what's that scripture verse I already told you about? Oh, by the way, it's smoke on the water.
Who is victorious?
No, that's the wrong song. How's smoke on the water go? Pat, how's smoke on the water go? Dude, you're a rocker. Come on. How's it go? Smoke on the lawn. Okay, to the lawn. I don't know how it goes. Anyway, come to Vacation Bible School Day number 4, you'll see. All right. Here's what I'd like to do in closing. We have a song, and it's a song that you're all familiar with. It's a song called On Christ the Solid Rock I Stand. And here's what I'd like to do. I'd like for us to, if you're able to, stand and sing this song together. And then I'm going to open up the altar. Where's my buddy? Is grandma here? Okay. Open up the altar for anything. But I would like, if you feel so led, to come forward and pray for a Vacation Bible School this week. We'll be presenting the gospel. This is a gospel evangelistic message. These stones are the redemptive ark of God. They start with our sin. They show us how far we've fallen. They tell us that Jesus is the only way to be saved. And then for those who saved, they get to be with God forever in a place called heaven. That's the redemptive ark of God. So we're going to sing this song, and if you're so inclined, we're going to open up the altar for prayer for Vacation Bible School and or other things that we're here to pray with you, Terry. I'll be done after that. And we are very excited about this week. Very excited. Okay, go ahead, Matt.
And 3 o'clock this morning, I thought, oh, darn, They're out back of the church. They're light. It's windy. Here they go. But you know, God is so good, even with small things like moss baskets. I came in this morning with Abby, and there they were, right where I left them. They hadn't gone anywhere, so they have a purpose. You're not going to get to use them because they're too fragile, I think, for the whole crowd this morning. We'll use our traditional offering plates, and as you are led, please support the church. They're right here, Mark, by Jeff. Please support the church in its efforts to reach out into the, you know, the community and indeed to the world. So if our offering team will come forward, there they come. The Shrews are at it.
Go Pirates.
Matt, would you give us some traveling music from Bible school?
Lord God, may your peace fall upon the people, Let your joy accompany them as they leave this place, the house of the Lord. As we go forth with the promise of your word, that is joy and salvation and overcoming. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
As you exit, the doors will be wide open except for all you people that are working here this week. You need to come down front. Oh, and look like the red cups at the back of the church when you leave, because they have a big purpose this week. Have a great week.
Thank you.